Hello everyone. So here is our next question. So this question is based on the recursion. So here we are given this recursive code and we have to tell that what is the output of this given code. And these are your four options. You have to pick the correct alternative or correct answer from these given four options. So I will start the timer and you can pause the video and you can first find the answer by yourself. And after that, I will explain the correct answer. So I hope you have got the answer. So the correct answer for this question is option C. That means 0, 1, 2 and 3. It will come as the output. So let's first run this program into our IDE and see what is the output. So here is our program. So let me run it. And we can see that our output is 0, 1, 2, 3. So let's see why we are getting this answer. So here you can see we have two functions, main function and this function fun. Okay, so main function is calling this fun with the argument 3. Okay, so 3 is actually passed to this recursive function. Now inside that we have if n is greater than 0, then we have to call this recursive function, and otherwise we are printing the value of n. So how this flow will go? So you know, when the recursive functions are called, then inside the memory, or specifically you can say inside the stack which is present in the memory, the activation records will be kept so that compiler can know, okay, what are the various activation record and where a function has to return when this stack will unwind. Okay, so I will put all the activation record here. Okay, first this main function is called. Okay, so main function is called actually by the OS. Okay, that you know. So main function is kept here. Now from here your function 3 is called. Okay, so you can simply say fun 3 is called. Okay, but the activation record will be kept actually in the next frame. Okay, now when this fun is called, so what you can do, you can draw this way also, fun 3 is called. Okay, I am not writing void, and inside that you can see ki these lines are kept. Okay, so this fun I am writing here. Okay, now for the first time we will say n is greater than 0. So you can see that this if condition will only be true whenever n is greater than 0. That means whenever n is greater than 0, this recursive function will be called. So currently n is 3, so 3 is greater than 0. That means this call will be made, and this is saying, okay, you just call n minus 1. That means 3 minus 1 is 2. So from here you can say now a next call will be made to the function with the argument 2. Okay, so you can see like a next copy will be made and fun 2 will be called. Okay, so this way also you can understand the recursive function. Okay, so in the activation record you can see that fun 2 will be called. Now here one thing to note is when you call the function 3, okay, this function 3, so you can see I came at this point. So here this n is a new n which is created. Okay, so you can see that n will be kept here with value 3. So all the local variable are also kept inside these activation records, right? Now when we call fun2, so we are here, right? So here we can see that here 2 will be actually now stored inside this n. Okay, now this is not 3. So again a new n will be created. So you can say this is new n. So in the same way you can keep n equal to 2 here. Okay, now 2 is greater than 0. Yes, so you will again call fun n minus 1. That is currently n is 2, so it will be 2 minus 1 1. So from here you can see inside this body fun 1 will be called. Okay, so a new fun 1 call will be made, right? The same way you can say fun 1 is called. Okay, now from here when 1 is called, that means this 1 will be copied here into this new n. So a new n is created with 1 value. Okay, now here now n is 1, so 1 is again greater than 0, so again fun n minus 1, that is 0 will be called. Okay, because current n is 1, so fun 0 will be called. So you can say fun 0 and we will come to a new call. Okay, this, the same way from here fun 0 is called. So that means when we are calling fun 0. So here 0 was coming, so this n is 0, right? So you can say when this n is 0, we will keep n equal to 0. Okay, so all the local values of this n are kept inside this activation record. Now if we see this if condition, this will be false. Why? Because n is now currently 0 and this is not greater than 0, so we will come to this printf line, right? So you can see that inside this if was there, but it was false, so we came to this pf, or you can say printf condition. Okay, so this printf line is saying that you print the value of n. Now what value of n we will print? So that value of n will be printed whichever is present inside this function call. Okay, so inside this function body, what is the value of n? So this n is actually 0. The same thing you can see here. Here n is 0. So your 0 will be printed for the first time, right? So your output will be 0 for the first time. Now what will happen? Here there is no line written. So simply this function will return to its previous caller. So from these function calls and these activation records, you can see that this fun 0 was called from where? It was called from here, that is fun 1 called this fun 0, right? In the same way, you can see here this fun 0 was called from this. So the stack will unwind and it will come to its caller, that is here. Now inside that, what is the next line written? So inside each body, or you can say inside each body, this printf will be written. Okay, because these recursive bodies are actually the copies of the actual function, right? So here again you will have printf, that is you have to print the n value. So here what is the n? So here this is n equal to 1, or you can say this is n equal to 1. So now 1 will be printed, right? Again after this we will return to the here. Okay, that is we will come inside the body of this function 2. So we will come here. Now here again we have to print the value of n, right? So what is the value of n? It is 2. So from here also it is 2. So 2 will be printed. Now again we will return. So we will come inside this function 3 body. Okay, we will come here. Now what is the value of n here again? So it is 3, right? So it is 3. We will print 3. Now from here where should we go? So we know when this function 3 was called from main, then only we came here and we created this body. That means from here we will actually go to this point. From diagram also, from this figure also, we can see from here we will come to main function, right? That means this part. And here nothing has to be done, so we will just simply return from here. So we saw that our output is 0, 1, 2, 3. And this all thing was getting printed when this calls were getting unwind, or this stack was getting unwind. Okay, so this was the conceptual question of the recursion, and you should know because it is asked in many of the companies interviews and also in the competitive exams like GATE exam and others. So yeah, you should be good in that concept. So I think you have understood the solution. So if you have any query or comment, please write down into the comment box, and please like and share this video. So now let's move to our next question.